Hello everybody, welcome to another Cut Day video, and today I'm doing this Cut Day update. I haven't been doing it in a while because I just feel like I don't want to keep talking about him. I don't know if this channel should just become a Cut Day update channel. I'm not against that happening. I just feel like sometimes the things that I do, I originally was trying to actually genuinely help the guy, but whenever I put like what I think is reasonable comments and shit, right, or reasonable advice to the man, he will just ignore it or he'll retreat further into some deeper corner. So the points just kept repeated again and again and again, and it's not just something like that I'm gonna keep doing if the points are gonna be repeated the same. So I only do it when there's something new that comes into the equation, you know. Otherwise it's very boring also, right? Everybody say the same shit, then he say the same shit back. I don't want to do that also lah, right? So, but today got new things, right? So, I'm actually responding to a recent video that he posted. For some reason, he's posting like his phone calls with the gallery of his little pictures again, you know? So this was a very, very long phone call, about I think 1 hour, almost 1 hour. I couldn't hear properly, but I think the phone call is between him and this longtime fan called Any Name Is Good Good.
Hello?
If you are in the community of Cut Day fans, like, you kind of know who Any Name Is Good Good is, like. And I think Any Name Is Good Good is somewhat neutral, and I think Any Name Is Good Good usually is quite clear that he does mean the best for Kurt, lah. But he also, I think, clearly, like most of us, enjoys the shenanigans that surrounds this man called Kurt Day, right? So I want to talk about this video and particularly one point that keeps coming up. In a way, this point is like Kurt Day's rebuttal to my previous video that I made where I helped him to plan his finances. So a quick recap here for those of you who have better things to do in their lives than to keep up with all this Kurt Day shenanigans. Kurt Day struggles a lot with money stuff, lah, basically. He works as a security guard and he earns below the medium or middle income in Singapore. And as a result, his life, I think, he has once described as poor and pathetic. And for us fans who is genuinely entertained by him, we also kind of want him to be able to improve his situation. So sometimes we try to talk to him to try to help him. And also it's very frustrating to see somebody just aimlessly blame society, blame government, when a lot of times the problem is themselves. So in response to a lot of us like saying, hey, why don't you do this, why don't you do that? Kurt Day, right, in trying to defend himself, released like a financial breakdown of how much he earned every month and then what he spent on every month to sort of illustrate like, hey, I earn this amount, right? And then all these things that I spend on, there's really no way for me to really spend and upgrade my situation or anything. My hands are tied. Look, you guys cannot blame me for making bad decisions because there is no space for me to do anything else with the money that comes in. Once it comes in, I have to spend on necessities and then out it goes. So what we were actually trying to tell him is that, dude, the things that you are saying as necessities in this list, a lot of it can be cut away. And his insistence and response is that you don't understand. These are essential services, right? I cannot cut them away. So I challenge you to plan a financial chart for me that helps me to make sense of all this. But in a way, what he's actually trying to say that he only clarified later was that I want you to plan for me, but you cannot change any of the items that I put inside. You're saying, hey, write a new thing for me, but you must be same as my old one. Then of course cannot. Then you ask me to plan for what? I copy your list, is it? Just to copy down the thing, is it? Oh yeah, I guess cannot. Dude, that's not what we're trying to say. We are trying to say a lot of these things can cut out one. Sorry, this is post-recording editing phase Wei Chun, and I just realized that actually he keeps saying this one thing that I did not address in the video, so I'm recording this to address it. He keeps emphasizing about the fact that all these lists of accounts that are made for him, right, don't make sense and ultimately fail because we are obsessed with talking about storage space 40 total, and that his challenge specifically was for us to only talk about all the essentials that he put inside, meaning all your milk powder, all this stuff. He keeps saying that our breakdowns are flawed because we keep emphasizing about storage space and lottery spending.
Focus on
玻璃多多这些，就是他们公布了，就不要公布一直 talk nonsense about solid space 这些，我听了都是被谁？我现在啊，我的很简单要求他们，他们都 ban 不到，一直公布，我没有那时候我就是 ban 到那个东西啊，我是不要放 solid space 先，OK？
没有
solid space， 没有 玻璃 多多啊，那些正常的 percent view 的 essential service 啊，都已经要推倒阵脚，因为我的意思是需要叫他们 ban 到这些东西，从那个什么客户啊那个。一直 talk 吧，所以这四百分之内，我的意思是，他边给我看呐，他边给我看。
So the moment we talk about storage space and 4D Toto lottery stuff like that, we are misrepresenting his spending. Well, the thing is, he is spending on these things. He is spending today, this month, the last month. He will spend the next month also on storage space. If not, how is he still having the storage space there today? So you are spending this money. If not, then how are you still having the storage space there? You tell me. You just magically have a storage space fairy, is it, that gives you money that you can only spend on storage space, is it? So how do I not talk about it? The reason why we keep saying it is because it's an objectively stupid thing for someone in your position with two kids, two parents below median salary to afford, to support, to just to put your old comics and your toys and your clothes. And I'm trying to tell you that that's not a good thing to do. So how can we discount mentioning these things on a video that talks about your spending? Say a lot of these things are stupid, you know, like he pays a few hundred dollars for storage space to keep things that he don't even need. He has 5 mobile SIM cards, and at one point last time he used to spend like I think $200+ on 4D and Toto, which is basically the lottery in Singapore. He also used to buy monthly SD cards and hard disks to store his footage on. Footage that he already uploaded to YouTube. And a lot of times I get it, like, you know, you make content, you want to keep the thing, but the content that he make also is like not very compelling, not very unique, always the same kind of thing. He'll do stuff like he eat his lunch, then he just film himself eating his lunch for more than an hour, by the way, and then he just store all that on a hard disk because the quality on YouTube is not that good. Well, you see the cinematic quality of his stuff that he put, also not very high level, so actually all this is needless spending. I've heard that he stopped doing that hard disk thing already, you know, so at least that's that. But he still spends like a lot of money on like paying for five SIM cards. He has 5 mobile phones. I don't know why, like he's doing big business like that. So basically, right, you have to accept his terms, when actually what we are trying to tell him is that his terms are unreasonable and are hurting him. So this, to me, this is a bit like if I have a friend who has lung problems and I care for this friend, right? So I try to convince my friend to stop smoking, and I say, hey bro, you gotta stop smoking. Here is a PowerPoint presentation of all the reasons why smoking is bad for your health, for your family, for your finances, and for your family's long-term survivability and needs, right? But instead of just him saying no lah, I like to smoke, or basically just going, hey, I admit, okay, I'm fucked up, I just wanna smoke, let me deal with the consequences. Instead of saying that, your friend goes, hey, 你不懂不要装懂, okay? Nicotine is an essential ingredient to my survival. You want me to quit, right? Give me a way of not smoking, but I can still put nicotine into my brain so I can feel the shock, because to me it's an essential service. But bro, I'm trying to tell you that nicotine is bad, right? Putting nicotine into your brain is literally what I'm asking you to stop doing, and it's literally smoking. It's the thing that's killing you, bro. So in this case, of course, let's zoom out a bit, right? Having a storage space and 5 SIM cards, of course, is not directly as fatal as putting nicotine into your brain, right? But a storage space and 5 SIM cards is basically a luxury and a privilege, right? Having a storage space and 5 SIM cards is not a necessity. If it was, then won't most people just have them? How many people you know got storage space and 5 SIM cards? I don't know a lot of people with that combination of things, you know? So it's not a necessity. You have to deal with it in the category of it being a want, right? Curtis, for example, says that SIM cards is a necessity because of his security work. Basically, he's a security guard. He spends like 12 hours just sitting there, right? Looking over the shipyard or whatever project that he's on, right? Security work. Legit work, fine, right? But he cannot stay awake, which is why he needs 5 SIM cards to be able to stream on multiple phones and also film himself while he is eating during his lunch break and watching multiple screens at the same time, because he's just that good.
When I saw this, 除了phone bill 有点离谱以外啊，其他的都是真正essential啦。
哎，不，你也是很夸张嘞，你有五个电话嘞，这样很无聊嘞。
因为我在朔风那边是做模的 ，OK。我现在的 vessel 啊，跟之前的 vessel 有点不一样。也是之前的 vessel， 你可以看到我为什么我可以每天去拍 Christmas、翻 New Year， 因为那个比较可以假装吧。现在这个很难。说、
哦、
唯一的办法让你 away 就是看 video 咯，看 video 他们不会给你 WiFi 的吧？说我得用自己 data 看一整晚嘞，我看 video 所以data 就用很多嘛。
We've presented with him logical solutions before, for example. Like, why don't you just, bro, download the whole season of whatever show you're watching, store it on your SD card, micro SIM card, whatever, put it on your phone, then watch it. You know, download at home when your internet broadband is free. Why do you need to stream it? What are you doing? You're doing streaming service for your colleagues, is it? Like, on demand, want to watch what, then watch what. This is not something that you probably have the luxury of doing. And affording this is killing you, right? Second one, he says that storage space is a necessity because his house is too small and he has a lot of like sentimental value things that he put inside. Some of his toys, I think like he likes Doraemon, so there's some Doraemon stuff inside. There's a lot of wrestling memorabilia, particularly like wrestling belts. And he also said in the recent phone call there's things like $10 wrestling t-shirts that he buy from the Pasar Malam, the night market kind, you know? So are these necessities? They're not, okay? And also I think it's dangerous also because this kind of tendency can lead to or be the signs of hoarding tendencies, which is actually a mental disorder, a legit mental disorder that I am not judging for. But if it's that the case that you are having this kind of thing, you should get it looked at and you should get it checked out, right? Because it's a real thing that can fuck with you really badly. There's a difference between a collection and a hoard, right? A collection is something that's organized, that you can display, that you can take stock of, that you go back to revisit and maintain.
好像我的东西全部是包在一个plastic bag， 然后这些东西我没有空这样一件开给你们看。
This is not that I think. It's just a storage space that he's throwing his things into. It's all in plastic bags. He can't show us. So I actually think, Kurt, if you're watching this, and I'm probably damn sure you're watching this, you need to watch that. You need to be careful of that. Go and Google hoarding mental disorder and look at that like, and see how many of the signs you qualify for. Because I think you need to watch for that, lah, right? So zooming out again, right? Let's talk about the money stuff. Storage space, 5 SIM cards. These are not bad things in and of themselves, right? It's not bad. But for somebody in your position, Kurt, for somebody struggling to make ends meet, with a wife that's not earning as much, two parents that are not working, two kids to bring up with plans to have two more kids to add to the equation, right? Your salary is just not high enough for you to afford the privilege of having a storage space and 5 SIM cards along with all the other things that you want, right? It's all contextual. It's not just good or bad. It's whether it's good for you or not. And your salary at the moment is just not able to help you afford these privileges. And you trying to afford these privileges is harming you, your financial situation, and also then in extension, your family's future and your future, right? In this case, I really believe storage space and 5 SIM cards along with all the other stuff that you buy that we are trying to tell you is not good, right? It's nicotine for your financial health. You want me to plan the chart for you so that it includes these things? Very hard lah, cannot lah, huh? But I'm actually trying to tell you, you should not be affording these things. And what we're trying to do when we plan these charts for you, because I'm not the only one that's planned this kind of thing for him, right? What we're actually trying to do when we plan this chart for you is to show you what your life can be like in a world where you are able to get yourself off of the addiction of having storage space, 5 SIM cards, and all this other stupid shit that you spend your money on. Dude, the burden of all these decisions, Kurt, is yours to bear. So I'm not that bothered if you listen. Part of the reason why I do this video is because I'm interested in personal finance, and I also think if it can help you, that'll be a good bonus. Now I'm also doing it because people ask me about it, and I think it's genuinely entertaining for people and also somewhat educational. I will say this as a general piece of unsolicited advice that you're not asking for, Hawker, that I think the meaning of being an adult, being a parent, and being mature means that you can, number one, understand and be able to rank and prioritize what is truly important in life. And number two, be able to not have some of the nice things that you want right now to have a better future in the long term, right? Not just for you, but for your family. So it's the idea of 先苦后甜, to know that some of the things that you're doing right now, right, you don't have them will cause you bitterness, cool. But in the long term, to give up some of these things, right, will be 甜 in the future, not just for you, but for your family. So you challenged me to make a chart for you. I made it, right? It did not meet your requirements, but dude, I made it. And I think you misunderstand what I'm trying to tell you when I make that chart. So now, I have a challenge for you, Kurt. Very simple. I also want you to make a chart. Well, not a chart, a list, right? There are many, many lists of Kurt Day that you put all the haters on. I'm probably on the list of half haters. I'm challenging you to make a list. Can you list down for us a ranking of the things you find the most important in life to the least important? So this list, right, should include things like your children, yourself, your wife, your parents, your ability to buy a HDB flat, and also things you want, like 5 SIM cards, 5 mobile phones, your storage space, your Lao Fu Zi comics, your wrestling belts, your $10 Pasar Malam wrestling t-shirts, 4D Toto. Some of these things that every day you spend money on, right? Make a list. List from 1 to however many, most important to least important. Do that for me and I'll do a video response and I'll tell you what to do with that list. Basically, it's relating to the number one point that I said just now. That being an adult, being a father, being mature, means that you can understand and prioritize the things that are important to you in life so that you can choose. Because we can never have everything that we want. There are a lot of things that I want I cannot afford. Not cannot lah, but I understand that affording something like that means that I cannot afford something else. I would like a car, right? It's not that I cannot afford it. I understand that buying a car means that I have less financial flexibility to deal with some other things, right? So it's a trade-off, and everything is a trade-off. You can't just have what you want. The moment you can afford it, then you buy, right? You gotta save, you gotta invest, you gotta plan for the future. And if you don't plan for the future may hit you fucking hard. What if there's a medical emergency, you know? How are you gonna pay for that? Got insurance or not? Your insurance can cover everything or not? Do you even know what your insurance can cover? Right? So all these things need to think about. If you can do it, plan for me. If you don't plan, if you cannot do this, then you also don't gong wu gong bo or whatever, right? And say that you are a responsible adult. To me, this means that you cannot be a responsible adult if you cannot do something simple like this. Don't pretend that you simply have no choice in life. Don't say that it's the government's fault. Don't say it's society's fault. Don't say it's your boss's fault. Don't say it's your parents' fault, okay? It's on you already. Because you are a fully able-bodied person, you got opportunity to make, I think, good enough money, and you have the ability to make the choices to not spend on some of these things, and you still have time. So don't pretend. 你懂怎么做个有责任的成人吗? 如果你不懂, 你就不要装懂。
Oh yes, I'm the great pretender. Adrift in a world of my alone.